The Albanese government plans to equip 2,000 Indigenous Australians with crucial skills required to gain employment. But service providers have questioned the plan and raised concerns about falling school attendance rates.
When the Productivity Commission released its Closing the Gap report last month, just 4 of 19 targets were on track. The government admits it has work to do.
No one can put their hand on their heart in this nation today and say that we've got the outcomes that we want, whether it be in jobs or whether it be the shameful fact that a young Aboriginal person in this country has got a better chance of going to prison than they do from graduating from high school.
One area of concern is employment. Skills Minister Brendan O'Connor says the government will invest more than $430 million to improve foundation skills for adults, including literacy, numeracy and digital skills. There will be a specific focus on Indigenous Australians. The government hopes to provide training to 2,000 Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people over the next 4 years.
If we're going to be fair dinkum about closing the gap on education, closing the gap on employment outcomes, we need to invest in areas that will allow Indigenous people, First Nations people, to acquire the skills that they need to do so.
But when he met with service providers and business groups at Charles Darwin University, the minister was presented with some hard truths. Leaders here raise concerns about ineffective programs standing in the way of Indigenous Australians getting real jobs and of the appalling school attendance rates in some remote communities.
Look, I do think this is a national problem. It's not alone. One in five adults, Indigenous and non-Indigenous, have foundation skill deficiencies. One in five, 20% of Australian adults have this difficulty, and that is not acceptable, frankly. And on top of that, as I say, Indigenous people have a higher proportion that have those challenges, and we need to attend to that.
The government hopes a voice to Parliament will help improve outcomes for Indigenous Australians.
I think what you will find is that in the delivery today, it'll be more around closing the gap and what it means to actually do that if we are successful in this referendum.
Matt Cunningham, Sky News, Darwin.